swords in.
My favourite thing in the museum were the Egyptian coffins because they were really colourful and nice to look at.
I think the Fitzwilliam's great because it's got such a range of things in it. You can see lots of children running around, and there's lots of young people running around and lots of older people not running around. But there's lots of exciting things to see, and I think it's nice to have something like that outside of London, because the British Museum's great, but the collection here is fantastic.
So my favourite part about the museum is probably the special exhibitions that come on. They're always really interesting. I really enjoyed the Quentin Blake one because I liked the wide range of pictures they had on display.
Our favourite Fitzwilliam memory is that we actually had our first date here.
Yeah. So that's our favourite memory of the Fitzwilliam Museum.
And we've been back pretty
basically weekly.
Since.
Yeah. It has to be the bust of the Madonna. I don't know her official name, but when the appeal was made last year to raise the money to buy her, I came and had a look and thought she was so beautiful I had to contribute. So that's why she's a favourite, because I feel like I did my bit to bring her here.
What makes Fitzwilliam special is its open access, its eclectic nature, its diversity, the fact that each director brings a new dimension. I was just talking to the person about the introduction of furniture that Tim's brought in. It's the sort of stuff I wouldn't have been interested in. I now actually have a real focus on it, and that's all down to the way that museum's curated, just the whole feel of the place. So that's why it's special.
Well, one of the best things for me when I first came here was seeing how tiny the Akkadian tablets are, because I thought they were going to be huge and they're actually like this big. And we have quite a lot of those, which is pretty interesting.
I've been living here for 45 years and coming constantly to the Fitzwilliam Museum. My friends from all over the world come to Cambridge because they want to go to the Fitzwilliam Museum, and I always bring them here. My friend from Australia came 2 months ago and a few friends after that. So we've enjoyed the Fitzwilliam a lot, and I come again and again.
Well, I think that what makes the museum special is the diversity of the collections. I think it's really great to see so many artifacts from all over the world all brought together into the one place.
What I really like is when I come in the door, I have this excitement about seeing something that I haven't seen before. And, you know, when I come to the Fitzwilliam, it's like, okay, this, you know, I'm going to find a new little area and experience something different, and the staff is great too.
But I'm also really impressed with the museum's efforts to sort of branch out into the community and do activities like bringing people in at night, and I think it makes the museum available to a wider demographic, which is a really great thing here in Cambridge.
What I have loved about this museum most is bringing my old father here every month. We come and often look at exactly the same gallery every time. We'll stand in front of maybe one or two paintings for 20 minutes or so, and he can't always remember that he's seen that painting before, but we stand and just marvel at the detail, particularly in the Dutch gallery, of the trees, the way the people are drawn, and he loves every minute of it, and that's very special for me.
My favourite part of the museum is probably the mummified cats, because I really like cats and I like Egyptians, and I like the idea that they kept their cats with them.
I can remember coming into the Fitzwilliam probably for the first time as about a five-year-old, so that would have been back in the late 1960s, and into the 70s I was a regular visitor then, because my grandma and aunt lived in Fitzwilliam Street just opposite the museum, so whenever it was a rainy Sunday afternoon, this is the place we'd come. And I suppose the museum's largely responsible for giving me a lifelong interest in certainly classical history, and from that I went on to take ancient history at A level and read archaeology as well. So thanks very much, Fitzwilliam.